Welcome to the show, folks.
How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. This is Nick with Tom Shaver's RV, and we are at the Allentown RV show this weekend. It's going to be today, which is Friday the 13th. We're here till 8. It runs all weekend long, so if you guys are around the area that watch on YouTube, make sure you come out and check us at the Allentown RV show. We're going to check out a 2023 Keystone Sprinter 25ML. This is their little one-slide rear kitchen, actually. But then you still have a closet slide in the front, which gives you a little bit more room in the bedroom as well. So at least you get that little bit of room. You get a lot of space back here in the rear kitchen, as you'll see when we start the walkthrough. So we're going to start this through. The dry weight on this unit, you are about, let me get that information for you. You're about 8756. So your gross is going to be about 11970. Your hitch weight on this, you're about 1770. So if you're looking in that 150 series, which means like a the 1500, it all depends on how your truck is weighted, what you can tow. You may be able to tow this unit, but a 2500 or F250 is definitely going to be the go-to truck for you to tow this unit. So wrap it up or not, let's go check out this 25ML, and we appreciate if you like and subscribe. We're almost to 1,000 subscribers. Once we get there, it's going to be amazing. So if you guys have liked already and you guys are subscribed, thank you again for subscribing in the channel. And let's look around this 25ML Sprinter. Alrighty, as we enter this Keystone Sprinter 25ML, you're going to be greeted with this beautiful rear kitchen look. This is more of a gray to white scale back here that they used on their colors. You're going to be, you do have theater seats. So you have theater seating here. They do have cup holders, and you do have a little storage room in the middle here, which is nice. Another big thing that I always talk about is windows. You have windows there, windows in the slide, window there, and window all around. As you can see, we have them all open. It's pretty hot in here, so we make sure we have some fresh air going through the whole unit. You do get a booth seating dinette as well, which that can go down to a bed for you. And then you do have this whole room. So that's going to be a big slide. So when this slide is in, you're basically going to come right into the middle, about here with the slide. So you won't be able to get to the refrigerator when traveling, but you'll be able to take it out if you need to. Keystone does use just their cable slides, so you're able to move pretty easily on the road. So you're able to get to the refrigerator if need be. And then taking to the back, 12-volt refrigerator. It's staying nice and cold for our drinks here at the show and food. So everything's staying nice and cold in there. Freezer is still pretty cold as well. Obviously, this is pretty frozen up in here that we have. You can see a little bit of fog on here. So freezer is kicking pretty well. You do have closet space and storage to the right side of it. And you have some storage space to the down right side as well. And then getting onto the kitchen, you have storage all above here. So you have it all throughout the way, which I'll open so you guys can see what type of storage we're working with. So you see the storage all the way in there, and I believe they do go all the way back to the corner. So if you look inside there, you get storage all the way back to the corner. So they're not wasting an inch of room in this storage area. And then you move to here on the right side of the microwave. And then the left side, they still give you some storage as well. So really good space there. Obviously you get your microwave here. You do get your three burner stove below, and you do get your fan above. So you do get your fan and your light as well. And then you still get your oven. It's an easy bake oven. Not too much you can do in there, but you still do a little something while you're camping. Still get a storage to the left there. And then you get all these storage drawers here. You get about four that are that size, which is really nice. And then below it, that is your storage below the kitchen sink. And you do have this deep sink as well, which is really nice. It's not spaced or separate, but you still get a nice deep dish sink. And then for hose, for watering and doing your dishes, really nice to do all that too. As you can see, the price on here, this is $68,654. Our show price, we're at $55,986. So that is where we're at with our show price this year. And then once we move to the left side, you get your TV up there. So it's right across the theater seats. So that's really nice. And then they do give you, as you can see, the lights turn in color, your fireplace in here, and then you get a Furion sound bar as well inside of this 25ML. And then they do give you a little coat jacket. They didn't do too much on this wall. You get a little keys. You can hang your keys up here if you want to. And then you get a nice little coat jacket if you want to hang your coats there as well. And then let's move on to the bathroom and the bedroom. Before we get into the bathroom part, this is going to be everything you need on the Sprinter. This is your fresh, your battery, your gray, your black, your gray tanks, Your ceiling lights are here. Your water pump is here as well. You have your both your slides out here. You have your awning light, and you have your battery heat. That's for the lithium batteries that are on this, that they're doing the Dragonfly batteries now on the Keystone units themselves. You have your in-command, so that is basically like your computer that you can hook up to your phone. That is your in-command light here. Right here, you can do a travel lock. You can pair it with your Bluetooth. Basically, travel lock, you really can't use your phone while traveling or on the road. And then your water heater is up here as well. And then while moving up, we'll head right into the bathroom. So with this, you do get some nice medicine cabinet area there. You get your sink. Your shower is still pretty good size, which I'll go in next so you guys can see the size comparison as well. To the left side, you get all this storage area, which are really nice and deep, so they're not wasting any space inside this bathroom area, which is where you really look forward for the storage, so they're not wasting a single space back there in that storage area. And they do give you below, they do give you all the storage below as well. And then toilet, so you can hear me knocking, ceramic, or porcelain, sorry, not ceramic, porcelain. And then you do get some storage below as well. Cabinet doors, so you get really good storage in here. And then I will show you the test of the shower. All right, shower test. Tallness, I got. So it's definitely like 6'5 in here that you can reach. So I definitely fit in there size-wise. Width-wise, my shoulder is definitely going to hit this door right here. But other than that, I can fit in. I can do a quick shower if I really want to. So shower height and size, not too bad. Decent big man approved, but all in all, I can definitely still get a quick shower in here. Head into the master bedroom. You do got your queen bed inside the cab. You're gonna have storage all the way around here. So you do have your storage underneath there. You got yourself above there as well. And then you have two that are actually above the bedroom that have some storage in it that you can put whatever you need, clothing, extras. You still have storage there, but the big thing is you have a closet. So this is your closet slide. So in here, you're getting all the room you need. Especially, you still get a little bit of room because the closet slide bunks out, but you're still getting a bed inside the cab. And then you're getting all this. You can actually hang clothes in here if you want to, but pretty big room to get a lot of clothes in there. And obviously, your queen bed. Underneath your queen bed, you are getting your space underneath it, as I can control my camera. So you do get some space underneath if you need anything else. Definitely chuck some storage bins in there and gain some room for storage. So that is it on the 25 ml, and we'll work ourselves on the inside next. Alrighty, working on the outside of this, starting up front. You're gonna see your hookup for a two battery lithium hookup. So that is where your Dragonfly batteries are gonna go in there. You do have your solar prep in there, but it does have a 30 amp controller already as well for you. You do have a panel disconnect as well, so you can actually disconnect fully when you're at home if you don't want to pull any solar. You do have that opportunity as well. Tire link prep is up there for you, and then you do have a full battery disconnect on that for both the lithiums and another disconnect as well. So there's about three disconnects in here just for a full solar system. Depends on what you're using. If you're boondocking or not boondocking, those would be chances of you want to turn it on or off. Or if you're fully at home and not using it, you want to make sure everything is off so nothing is drawing power for you. As you can see, your electric levelers are over there too as well. But that's going to be the full front bay for you here. And working to the other side of the storage. If it's open for me, if not, that's okay. That is your electric leveling right there. So everything controls from the outside, and also your auto leveling. In here is going to be your two propane setups. We take propanes out for the show, but you can't see it, but two 30-pound propanes will be in there for you too. And then storage on the other side. So this is your full pass-through storage for this unit on this side for you. And then you do see the inverter in there for you too. So your inverter is actually up underneath the storage unit inside. And then docking station, so everything like your water hookups are all inside of here too. All right, working on the campsite. So this is gonna be the other side of the pass-through storage. You have your in-command system. That's everything that happens on the mobile phone. Everything is in there, anything goes. That's your number one spot to go to fix it, but that is where your command center is gonna be. You do have a TV hookup behind the door here for you, and two 110 outlets And then you do get your Lippert steps out here, and then they do have that big step up top, which is about 12 inches up top. So you can fit your whole foot there and come down if your shoe size isn't a 12 foot. But these are really nice stairs that they put on for you. This does have the solar 400i. If you guys look on Keystone, they're gonna have a 2, a 4, a 6, and then they jump to 8 or 1,000. But it's just the different packages if you get an inverter or not with your system. Your dual axle system has a 4-point leveling, so you got levelers up there and your levelers up front as well. And then you do have the road armor for your suspension as well. You have your tankless water heater here. So that is your tankless water heater on this side. And then you do get a little mini fridge in the back here. I said we're at a show, don't mind food in here or drink, but you do have a little mini fridge in the back of this unit. And this also does have a ladder, so you can go up and check your seals every year if you want to, but you do get your ladder in the back. But that is gonna be it for 2023 Keystone Sprinter 25ML. Thank you guys for joining us. Make sure you hit a like, hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you guys later. See ya.